I have a bunch of shapes here. Let's think about what they are. So this first shape here, you probably recognize it. It's the shape of the moon in the sky, at least on a full moon. And we call it a circle. Now, what makes it a circle? Well, when you get further in math, we come up with fancier ways to define a circle. But one way to think about it is if we take the center of the circle, and if we go across, if we go from one side of the circle to the other side of the circle through the center, that's always going to be the same length. So that's the same length as this, as long as we go through the center of the circle as that. Now, if that's a circle, what would something like this be? Well, you might call this an oval, and all circles are ovals, but this oval is not a circle, because if you have its center, say right over there, this distance going in that direction is going to be much shorter, or just shorter, than this distance right over here. So this one right over here is not a circle, this one is. Now what about this shape over here that has three sides? One, two, three. You could also say it has three corners. One, two, three. Well, if you have three sides, we call that a triangle. Triangle. Whenever you see this tri right over here, that's a good sign that you're dealing with the number three. This is a triangle, has three sides. Now what about these shapes over here? These shapes are interesting. How many sides do these shapes have? Well, if you count them, you see that this one up here in purple has one, two, three, four sides. This one has one, two, three, four sides. This one has one, two, three, four sides. This has one, two, three, four sides. So they all have four sides. So our name for any shape that has four sides is quadrilateral. 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 And when you see this quad at the beginning of the word, that's a pretty good sign that you're dealing with the number four. Four sides. Four sides. That's what quadrilateral means. But these are all different special cases of quadrilaterals. And actually, you could even have a quadrilateral that looks like this. You could even have a quadrilateral that looks like this. One, two, three, four sides. As long as it has four sides, it's a quadrilateral. But let's think about each of these. So this shape right over here, what you might see is the corners all come in, sometimes this is called square, or sometimes you could call it a right angle. So, and notice, I could put little small squares here. So if all four corners are square, or they all come in at a right angle like this, then you are dealing with a rectangle. You are dealing with a rectangle. And so just to be clear, this down here is not a rectangle. Notice this corner right over here, if I tried to put a little square here, it would either look like this, and so it doesn't, the two sides aren't on two sides of the square, or it would look like this. So this is not a square corner, and neither is this. So this is not a rectangle. All four corners need to be square. This one also is not a rectangle. Notice the corners are not right angles. So this isn't a rectangle. This isn't a rectangle. What about this? Well, I can do that. I could put little squares in the corner, or I could see that they are all right, all the corners are right angles. So this actually is a rectangle as well. So these are both rectangles. Now you might recognize this purple one on the left as a special type of rectangle. Not only are all of the corners square, not all do they have these right angles, but all the sides are the same length, or at least it looks like it from this picture. This side is the same length as this side, the same length as that side, same length as that side. So if all the sides are the same length and all the corners are square, or they have right angles, well then we call it a square. So this right over here is a square, special type of rectangle. This one, not all the sides are the same. This one, all the sides are the same. Now what if we go down here? It looks like all the sides are the same. One, two, three, four. But it doesn't have square corners. Notice, if I tried to put a little square here, it wouldn't fit perfectly. If I tried to put a little square here, it doesn't fit perfectly. These aren't right angles. So if all four sides are the same, and that's all we know about it, we call it a rhombus. We call it a rhombus. So you might be saying, wait, the square, all four sides are the same. Is that a rhombus? Yes, it is. So the square is a rectangle. It's a rectangle. And it is a rhombus. So this last shape here, this last quadrilateral, what's interesting about it is you have two of its sides going in the same direction. So this one right over here, notice, what do I mean by the same direction? And sometimes this is called parallel. If I draw two lines here, these two lines are never going to cross each other. So these two lines are parallel. If you have one pair of opposite sides that are parallel, we call them trapezoids. We call them trapezoids. Notice, the other lines, the other opposite sides, these will cross. These will cross eventually. So that right over there is called a trapezoid.